Less than a minute away. What's the official countdown clock say?
All right, we're 30 seconds right now. This is a big deal. I mean, we're changing really direction of what we've done with the television station for the last 56 years.
And Bill, you work with the legendary Charlie Hall, who is no longer with us, but he signed Channel 5 on the air. Technically, we're signing off that same signal. We're going to sign it off right now.
He did. He said Channel 5 is now alive 56 years ago. Right now, we'll say Channel 5 is alive in the new century as we broadcast in digital television. Are we ready?
Let's do it, Bill.
Four, three, two, one.
There we go.
Channel 5 is now alive as WCSC DT, Digital Television, and we are starting our new show now at 6 o'clock live.
Now, in high definition, the Lowcountry's news leader. This is Live 5 News This Morning.
I'm Bill Burr here on Friday, June 12, 2009. I'm broadcasting live inside our transmitter building here in Ondaw, South Carolina. We're just moments ago. We signed off the original signal that we used to broadcast on Channel 5 for the past almost 56 years. And with me on this momentous occasion is Chief Meteorologist Bill Walsh. Bill, come on over here.
I am.
I'm kind of shaking here. Kind of a huge deal here.
This is amazing. It's a monumental step. I mean, we've moved into the new century. We've talked about digital television for years. Now it is happening. This is something that's going to be a major deal as people wake up in the morning. If they don't have a converter box, they're not going to be able to see Live 5. But we've been talking about it for over a year, and this is certainly something. If you look at this, is now our analog signal, which is really not a signal anymore since we've turned it off. But once again, if you have cable, you're watching us with no problem, satellite, no problem, and of course with the digital converter box or one of the new high-definition televisions, another first for Live 5, the only station in South Carolina now broadcasting in high definition. Our newscasts are all in high definition. We started that back in September.
And Bill, one of the reasons Live 5's transition to digital TV was made possible is because of our transmitter here in Ondaw. The planning for this went on for many years. When it was built in the 1980s, it was a groundbreaking move that took Charleston TV to new heights.
Reaching New Heights was the special live broadcast that aired on WCSC September 15th, 1986. It was the beginning of another era in Lowcountry television.
This is the dedication, the opening of the new tall tower.
The late Charlie Hall hosted the event from Ondaw, the new home of the TV station's $6 million state-of-the-art transmitter.
Today is a momentous occasion for Charleston television and radio.
John Rivers Jr. was the president of WCSC Incorporated. He was one of the people who led the effort to build what would be known as Tall Tower, the biggest broadcast transmitter in South Carolina.
Instead of the signal going around just this way in an orbit, it would go not only this way, it would go this way, and therefore it would be able to get into the homes or to cable more effectively.
Rivers says the improved signal strength would reach almost half the state, covering most of the coast, half the Midlands, and part of the PD.
It increased our reach. It gave us a larger audience base, and so if we had a larger audience, we could theoretically charge our advertisers more.
The new facility also allowed Live 5 to begin broadcasting in stereo. Tall Tower was a big change from the old transmitter on Rifle Range Road in Mount Pleasant. Built in 1959, this tower was only 1,044 feet and didn't allow its signal to be sent as far. Today, Tall Tower is part of the next generation of digital television, used by an experienced team of dedicated broadcast professionals.
You can have all this wonderful technology, but until and unless someone is smart enough to put information that is appealing to a viewing audience on it, that technology really doesn't mean anything.
And John Rivers Jr. is very correct. You know, we're so blessed here at WCSC to have a talented group of professionals both in front of the camera and behind the scenes that have made this event possible today. Again, this has been years in the making. It's cost a lot of money, but fortunately the transition is now over. Our focus right now is making sure that our viewers across the Lowcountry, up and down the coast and into the Midlands, are able to watch Live 5 in crystal clear digital TV. And McGill, we're going to talk to you right now in the news center. You're going to be talking with some professionals and some of our Live 5 staffers to help our viewers that may be having some problems right now with this transition.
panicking and pushing on.
All right, and we are so close to this. We're about 20 seconds away to making this transition. It is one button. This analog transmitter will be completely turned off. I would say 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. That is it. Our analog transmitter is turned off. And you can see up top, hopefully, no one's looking at this. This is what happens to folks who were not prepared. Down here, this is our digital HDTV that is good to go. And congratulations to all of you who made it into this new era successfully.
Yay.
Even the FCC guys said that this is a hassle for a lot of people. But in the end, they are saying that they are really going to benefit from this big change. So bye-bye, analog. You are now a dinosaur digital.